Hi, kids. I have a challenge for you. July 2nd, 1937, Amelia Earhart, an aviator that had sort of worldwide fame, disappeared. And there are so many theories about this, but when she was last seen, of course, she was flying her favorite plane. She was flying a Lockheed Electra. And so this plane was a very interesting plane in its time, and it had been modified so it could fly farther and hold more fuel. But so I have a challenge for you, actually a two-part challenge. What I want you to do is, and I'm going to go ahead and just look this up real quick. I'm going to look up Amelia's Electra, just to find a quick picture of the plane. Okay, so let's now look at an image here. Okay, and let's see what it looked like. Okay, so it's kind of a cool looking plane. Let me see if I can pull up an image of it and just sort of do a quick sketch. So here it is, and back in its day, this was pretty cutting edge. Okay, so we got sort of a fuselage that goes like this. Okay, so it goes like this, and it sort of comes down sort of like this, and then it sort of has this sort of nose conus like this, and then this part here is gonna go back like this or so, and then it's got this sort of cross wing like this, right, and then sort of this and sort of this. Okay, so as I'm doing this, I want you to be thinking about if you were going to work together with other classrooms, other places in the world, and divide this plane into pieces. Okay, so let's say one classroom is going to do this part, right, that's going to be the fuselage and the tail. Another classroom is going to do this part, which is the wings, right? So how far do they come out? What are the measurements? And by the way, if you're doing this scale, like 1/3 scale, how big is all of this stuff, right? So if this is 1/3 scale, 1/4 scale, how big is this plane? It's probably fun to have the plane be fairly large. That might be kind of cool. So what's it look like over here? So one school is making the wings. And one school, maybe one school is making the tail wings and the front wings. One school is making the fuselage, right? That's this part here. This is kind of coming out, and you got this going on, and you got this going on. What were the changes that they made to Amelia's plane to make it fly so far? You know, were there adjustments made? What does the research tell you? And you're going to have to do a lot of research to find these things out. These big old engines, and these are huge engines, right? And they sort of bisect the wing, so at this angle they would be a little bit oval, and they kind of come back into the wing here a ways underneath, right? And there's one over on this side, a little different at this angle to see, right? And then these have propellers, right? These big old propellers. And then, of course, they're moving. So if this plane is in flight, of course, they're going to look a little different, right? They probably have some motion marks or whatever. But anyway, so what's it look like to design this plane with other people? And there are some couple of lights in the front of this plane that make it kind of an interesting plane. Okay, so here's the challenge. I want you to connect three classrooms together, right? So one classroom is going to make the fuselage. One classroom is going to make the wings. One classroom is going to make the engines. And you're all going to ship your parts at whatever scale you've decided. You're going to ship your parts to a fourth classroom that's going to do assembly. It's going to assemble the whole thing. So the fourth classroom assembles. And this also means that the fourth classroom also has to coordinate with all of these other classrooms to make sure that it's all going to work, right? That the measurements are all going to work and it all goes together. You'll have to decide on things like, how do these wings attach to the fuselage? How does this wing attach to the fuselage? How do the engines attach to the fuselage? And I'm not done yet, okay? So the first part of this challenge is all about building. Right? Measuring, building, researching, that sort of thing. Right? Let's take it one more step. There's research involved here. So kids, you're going to have to research. You're going to have to figure out your measurements. You're going to have to look for schematics. You're going to have to build your parts, work together, collaborate, communicate, cooperate with other schools and other places. Awesome. Let's go deeper. Okay. I also want there to be a team of kids at each of these locations, right, that does the story. Right? What are our theories? What are our theories about what happened to Amelia? Did she crash into the ocean and die that day? Did she crash onto an island and survive and put out transmissions around the world that made it as far as North America. And eventually, you know, the tide pulled the plane into the ocean. Did she die a castaway on an island? Was she captured by the Japanese? There are so many theories out there. So what I want is I want teams from each of these schools, these same schools, right, to research and tell the story of what they think happened to Amelia, right? So these are all, they're all going to tell the story, and the fourth school here is also going to tell their story. Now what happens here is you're going to make a video and put it on YouTube, right? And you're going to generate a QR code. And the QR codes are going to go on the outside of the plane, right? So there'll be 1, 2 on this side and 1, 2 on the other side. So when people look at this plane, and you will share pictures online where the QR codes are very visible, and anyone seeing it live can just scan the QR code and you'll pop up, your team will pop up and give your best theory as to what happened. So I'd say a 2 to 3 minute video that sort of details what you think happened to Amelia Earhart after and during her expedition, her trip to fly around the world. So here's the whole challenge in a nutshell. Okay, so if this is interesting to you, I'm going to start a Google Doc, and there'll be a link down below this video where you can go and sort of form up your teams and decide how you want to do this coordination here. And you guys, reach out to those other schools and work together. Make sure your pieces fit together. Let's learn some 21st century skills while we're solving a big mystery and building something fun. See ya.